He was actively involved in National Hydrology Project. He also worked as Director General, Maharashtra Engineering Research Institute, Nashik, and then he worked as Secretary, Command Area Development at Water Resource Department, Government of Maharashtra, and he retired in July 2020. He is honorary member of many institutions and also founder and vice president, past vice president of Ferrocement Society of India. Ferrocement technology is his passion, and I request him to start the webinar. Before that, just I want to explain all the participants that if they want to raise any question or want to involve in the discussion, there is a question box on your screen. You can type your questions anytime during the webinar, and also you can raise your hands. When the lecture will be over, you will be unmuted from our side, and then you should unmute yourself as explained on the screen, and then you can start speaking. Thank you. And again, request Pawar sir to start the webinar. Thank you.
Hello, good morning to all. I'm really delighted to be among you all again, maybe after the gap of 6 months or so. I was asked to talk about this ferrocement technology and its applications in our water resources department. But I'm not going to give you much of a technical information as such. But basically, just to know what this technology is and what the different applications it can be to the help of our WRD. So it will be a kind of journey, how to begin with, to know the ingredients, the material characteristics, and basically focus on the applications so that you will come to know the versatility of this material, and on your own you can decide much more applications of this. So let us start the presentations. This ferrocement is actually not any type of cement. The basic thing is it's a new construction material, like PCC, RCC, and steel, wood. It's a different kind of material having different properties. So if you compare this ferrocement material with the RCC, there is a difference between the properties and characteristics of this material. So just to understand, I will simply give you one example. Consider a beam, say having size of 8 inches by 12 inches, and we are having a reinforcement, main reinforcement, four bars of 16 mm diameter at the four corners and bound by the stirrups. So in these, we all know, while designing as an RCC, the central axis, horizontal, divides this section in two parts. The lower half, it takes the tension part, and the upper half takes the compression, we all know. But here, the tension is taken only by the steel. The concrete is very poor in taking tensions, you know. So the two reinforcements in the lower part and their bonding area that governs the total tensile strength of this concrete section, right? And the half part takes only compression. Here, imagine if we compress this section, the height of 12 inches, just to 2 inches, like a slab. And there, if we spread these two bars having 16 millimeter diameter into a smaller mesh, like a welded mesh, having only 2 to 3 millimeters diameter, then the bond area of the concrete and the steel surface increases 1,000 times. So this advantage is taken to increase the tensile strength of this ferrocement material. So this is very simple technique we have used. And here the tensile strength as well as the compression also increase by taking the form. Suppose you give that section a little curvature, then the member goes into fully compression. So this way we can enhance the properties of the regular RCC to increase its tensile strength as well as the compression strength. I think let us start about the presentation. In my presentation, I will be covering what is the basics of ferrocement, what are the special features, what are the ingredients used, the unique properties and characteristics of this material, and a little point, some points, major points about the design of ferrocement structures. And for that, what are the available references, books and manuals. And then we'll go on seeing the various general applications of this material through the photographs and one video. There are some special creatures executed using this ferrocement technology. And lastly, we'll be seeing the exact applications of this technology into the water sector. So let us begin. What is ferrocement? And say this is a construction material of a new millennium. Why? You will come to know. Incidentally, it is called as ferrocement or ferrocrete. Both ways it is called. Internationally, it is well known as a ferrocement. So this is a simple picture I am showing to begin with. Just name any shape and ferrocement gives it to you. Just imagine constructing this kind of material into RCC. How to design, how will the members, how to cast, all these things are easily solved by this technology. About this building, how much formwork will be required, how much centering. So constructing such buildings in ferrocement technology is very easier and cost effective too. This is a simple bar. Just imagine casting this into PCC or RCC. If it is having a small size, say 2 inches, 3 inches, well, you can cast in PCC as regular concrete. But to a size of say 1 foot or 2 foot, how to cast it? Even in RCC, it is very difficult. But the ferrocement gives a simple solution like this. It's just a football, a chicken mesh is wrapped around, and you can just impress the mortar around it, and the ball becomes very sturdy and strong. This is another example, beautiful creation of this ferrocement. This is another one. A flower pot put upside down, some chicken meshes and some structural scale elements wrapped around to give a proper shape. There is no formwork as such, and just cast it in cement mortar. Now imagine creating this structure in concrete. Well, this is the basic skeleton. The chicken meshes are wrapped around the members. Then it is mortared and given a finish of wood so that it will look like a wood. And this is the finished picture. This is another example, a sofa set. Just showing you some unique constructions, how this technology can very nicely be used for creating such beautiful structures, giving the perfect shape, perfect touch and everything. See, this is a flower pot entirely made in ferrocement. Let us go to the buildings now. So there are different uses of Peru cement in building. Right now, we cannot construct this such a multi-story building in Peru cement as compared to. There are some limitations, but the many components can easily be casted in Peru cement, which will ease out to reduce the cost as well as the workability. And have the shade roofs, the roof slabs, the lightweight partitions, the facades, then some paving material and whatnot. We'll see in detail in my next slides. So the basic principle used here, as I already explained, is like attached walls using mud mortar, which are common in rural huts, we have seen. The same principle is used here, which is more durable and sustainable. So even though it is not directly replacing RCC, but it can economically used for the specific purposes. And we are not going to replace the buildings totally. But our focus today is its applications in water resource departments because of its unique another property, which is the water tightness. How we will see it. So what are the special features of this material? These are the advantages. It's labor intensive work, so which can provide work to many people. Economic, very high structural strength, ease of construction, ease of maintenance and repairs, long lasting, waterproof, crack proof, seismic proof. All these unique properties this material is having over the RCC. Basically, you can term this as a thin wall construction, and the required strength is achieved through the shape of the structure. So, welding the steel skeleton in fabrication shops, it provides control over the shape and size of the member. So, this skeleton steel is not more than 10 to 12 mm for in any case for any large structure. The smallest is 6 mm for the skeleton. And the rest is only chicken meshes and wire meshes. So through these, through shapes as shells, domes, pyramids, folded plates, we can create huge structures with a lightweight property. There are some many other features also. Equal and uniform distribution of steel throughout the body of the structure. This is the uniqueness of this material. Is not in case of any RCC. So this gives equal strength in both the directions. Thus, there is no formwork required, no centering required while casting. That saves on labor and also time. Big and costly machinery is also not required. And you can have the cast in situ products, or you can precast it and assemble it on the site. Both ways is possible. So this is about the unique features. Now let us see what are the ingredients. Only four basic materials are required: 6 to 8 mm steel bars for the skeleton, types of meshes, maybe welded meshes, chicken meshes, etc. Many number of layers are to be put, and regular OPC and sand. Here, as compared to RCC, the force aggregate is totally eliminated. Formwork and centering is also eliminated. So with this, we can achieve the concrete strength up to grade M40. Again, this is a matrix of cement mortar, regular cement proportion 1:1.5 or 1:2. The water cement ratio is very low, and the mortar strength is increased by some kind of fibers or polymer impregnation, or even by pre-stressing. These are simple materials. You can see the steel structures, welded meshes, chicken meshes, which are easily available in the markets. The meshes comes in the form of rolls. This is the machinery required for the production casting. No big machineries are required. Now, how this is casted? Here you can see the main bars, which is a skeletal steel of 10 to 12 mm diameter. I think normally spaced more than 300 to 500 millimeters according to this structure. And to increase the bond area, the layers of chicken meshes are tightly placed over that to the both sides of the skeleton, and then it is simply casted with the help of cement mortar. The closely binded steel and meshes looks like this, and this gives the final shape of the structure, so no formwork or centering is required. Here the tying of meshes is most important because it has to hold the mortar in between those meshes, and the skeleton should be completely buried in that. And through this we can achieve very thinner and slim sections. The welding of cages can be done in any shape in the workshop, and then we can put it on the side. The equal reinforcement in both directions, this is the uniqueness of it. If you have to cast a say water tank of this, the reinforcement in any direction is equal. It is having high strength in all directions. This is the casting process. Very simple, like this, and this way. Big structures without any formwork and centering can be erected like this, the basic skeletal steel as well as this. This is the second stage, the casting has started. This is the casting and the stage for this completion of this. Now let us rush through the properties and characteristics. We have to see the applications much more. There is no formwork in this construction, as I already told you. The strength is achieved through the various shapes and its behavior of the structure. The increased bond area with the mortar, and it's better for the water retaining structures as well as the soil retaining structures. Because of the chicken meshes, which are closely spaced, there is complete crack control. So that's how this material is waterproof. So it doesn't allow crack even to develop. So that's why the water leakage is not at all possible. I already told equal strength. So this is very simple construction technique. We can use it in rural areas, specifically training some of our youths, and they can even start their own business using this. This is same quality cautionary material, because you need to have exact water cement ratio to mix the mortar. Unless it is correct one, the mortar doesn't hold in between the meshes, so it is self-quality cautious material. This is having high strength to weight ratio. In case of RCC, we know it is around 30 to 35. In case of ferrocement, it is double, more than double. These are different advantages. You will come to know as we see its applications. This is a comparison given, the maximum diameters used, the bond strength, and different regular parameters. Some properties are governing the designs. So basically, it's homogeneous as compared to RCC. Bond area increases, also the tensile strength increases. Crack resistant. This is the main unique property of this. This is general comparison, the use of cement and steel. Cover you can keep only up to 2.5 to 5 mm, that is sufficient here. In case of RCC, minimum cover is 12 to 40 mm. And by reducing the size, you will reduce the dead weight of the whole structure. So this is another advantage, where the foundation, even having the less bearing capacity, you can erect the big structure, so that the regular design concepts we can use even for designing these ferrocement structures. To design, I would not go to the technical details of that. There are many books available, the other things are available. We'll see, focus on the applications mainly. So, considering all these properties, we have to design the ferrocement structure requirements. This is another concept. The ferrocement elements can be used as lost forms. If you are even constructing a conventional RCC framework, and we use the plywood to as a formwork. So you can use the pillow cement to cast the formwork first, and then you can put the RCC in between. So this composite structure can be a more having more strength, and such structures can also be designed. What are the references available so far? In our own Mary Nasik, we have done research of this material way back in 1991, and a technical report has been published. It is still available in Mary's library, I suppose. And we have recommended this material to be used in the Water Resource Department. This research was done in 1988. One wall was constructed right in the Mary building. Some water tanks and one boat. All these structures were casted, tested, and the technical report has already been published. I think this is the same water tank which is there in the Berry campus, still very intact even after 30 years. This is the same water tank. Now, these are the different tests, quality control tests we can do as similar to RCC. IIT Roorkee is also doing the research on this material. This is the first ferrocement hut they have casted in their own campus. IIT Delhi is having a structural engineering research center. They are also, they are doing many research activities in ferrocement. This is our own handbook published by our government of Maharashtra Water Department on ferro cement technology. Complete handbook is available where you can get all the details of even designing. These are the textbooks and manuals available in the market. Those are also used in for the academic purposes too. The complete design procedure has been elaborated in these books. There are proceedings of national and international conferences right from 2011, and there is a provision in our own schedule of rates having the items of this ferro cement technology, and can easily design the structure and make the estimation. There are some IS codes also available. This is the IS code for precast ferro cement water tanks up to 10,000 liters capacity. Similarly, there is another code of practice published by Ferro Cement Society. And a regular IS code is also under progress by the Bureau of Indian Standards. News bulletin is also published about the cement news, and these are different books available. So with this, with the help of all these references, we can easily design our own structure. Now let us see the general applications. So many applications are there. I'm not going to read it for you, but I will show you the more photographs of it so that you can get an idea how this can very nicely be used. It's suitable for low cost housing, eco-friendly housing, since it doesn't use any kind of timber, the reduction of the use of steel. The smaller units in rural areas like say toilet blocks, water fountains, swimming pools, temples, even the big industrial sheds, septic tanks, all such applications are there. The uniqueness is about the retrofitting of old RCC structures. If some RCC structure is damaged or the steel is corroded, concrete is pulled out, then you can jacket it by a thin ferro cement wall and strengthen the same structure with the help of this technology. And this is a picture of a village, and here you can find out how many applications can there be. Like the ferro cement gutters, you can have huts, you can have road pavements, a shelter for cattle, electric poles, signposts, tree guards, biogas plants, barricades. So many applications are there. Like this, the precast toilet blocks are now widely used in rural areas. These are the different applications again. Many big structures can also be constructed through this, like water retaining structures, soil space structures. We'll see the one by one. The water retaining structures like large size water tanks having up to even 1 crore liters, swimming pools of any shape, linings to canals and small channels, all these things can be done through like this. This is a 12 lakh liter capacity water tank constructed in Pune near Talegaon. There are applications for soil retaining structures like walls having height more than 1-3 meter also. This is a typical example of it. The space structures like large size domes. The domes can very easily be casted in Pelur cement as compared to even at a 1/3 cost, because we don't need any centering or formal high-rise chimneys and hyperbolas. These different shapes can very rightly easily be given. This is a school building in Pune city itself. Pencil shaft is actually a staircase shaft made in Pelur cement. Beautiful domes. This is a hotel. You can see so many pyramids in Pelur cement. This is a lining done to the swimming pool which was leaking. The rectification was done 100%. Here is a unique example of a nala diversion through Pelur cement in Pune city near Matre Bridge, where that nala was diverted through this long kind of pipeline, but it is having some irregular cross section and casted in situ around 800 meters long, and the entire nala was as its goes in the same alignment it was casted. This is another fantastic usage of Pelur cement. It's a totally Pelur cement casted boat, and of course it will never get submerged. Some elevation treatments can be given for the beautification of buildings like this, pergolas, beams. Even these columns you see, those are hollow Pelur cement columns, and that's why the cost and even the total dead weight of the structure has been reduced and become very light. Now let us see the applications of Pelur cement in public sector, where it can be used on mass scale. And by doing on mass scale, you can certainly reduce the costs, and you can go for the precasting technique and again reduce the time also. So you can see the public works departments can use in so many applications for the buildings, even roads, and for the flyovers also. So let us not much discuss about the other applications. We'll focus on the applications in water. But there are some special creatures which are already existed. I'm going to highlight so that you can understand it properly. Some specially featured structures have been casted in our own Maharashtra and India and also abroad. I will show you the different things. This is a small cabin with arches, side beams, totally casted in Pelur cement. This is the skeleton used for such kind of. You can see there is no formwork, no centering is required. You have to just cast it. The wall thickness can be maximum up to say 50 mm also. More than that, it is not required at all. This is a huge structure, an industrial shed. This is the first ever Pelur cement boat casted by V.D. Joshi from Pune around say 50 years back. So it is still intact. This can be casted. And now we will see the applications in water sector in detail. In our department, we know we have constructed the huge and massive structures like dams, many aqueducts, barrages, having complicated designs. But we have to keep the quality control very good so as to have the leak proof structures. The water retaining property is most important. But in case of irrigation projects having long water distribution network through canal system, we are wasting almost 50% of water through leakages. 20 to 30% loss to the transit, then there are seepages, there is evaporation, and even through the distribution network. So because of this, the coefficient of rugosity, the roughness of the surface area, also get reduced, and that's why the discharge is also reduced. So to get the water loss to the zero, we can stop these leakages through masonry dams by rectification work using this technology. Some ornamental and aesthetic shapes can be given, like spillway piers, entrance gates, various cabins on dam tops, statues, fountains. Then some designs like KTVLs, RCC retaining walls, small bandaras, some storage tanks, all these applications in our own water sector. We can use this technology very nicely. Then the retrofitting of the old structures, like the repairing of the canal linings, some cross drainage works like aqueducts. You can give the lining to the aqueducts box to reduce the leakages. If the diamond piers are damaged, you can jacket it through the cement. The VRBs can be rectified. So all these problems can have the better solution if you use this cement technology. Here are some possible applications. Leakage through dams can be reduced. The canal lining can be done. You can have the KTVL needles or even the entire KTVL structure right in the cement. Or precast structures like turnouts, blocks, outlet gates, watchman's cabins, gauges, road pavement blocks, gutters, all these can be made in this cement technology in a precast way, or even some portable units if you need, and we can use it. Some kind of structures can be casted. I think we designed our CD works by CDO in RCC. Those are having a very big sections. Using this technology, you can design very slender sections, aesthetically good. The dead weight is lesser, and having the very less bearing capacity is required. So we should go for this kind of structures and design it using this technology. You can also have big structures like storage tanks, elevated or underground, and some dams can also be constructed using this. Parallelly, this also can be very nicely used for water conservation works. We can have a chain of cement bandaras constructed over the nalas and with a standardized design. So you can precast it on factory or even on site and then assemble it. So very quickly you can construct any bandara in much lesser time and the cost. This is a typical canal lining, first ever tried on the Punad canal in Nasik district. This was the experimental reach we have casted. Without any, even the expansion joint or construction joint, you can continuously cast this lining even up to 300-400 meters. So this gives a complete leak-proof material. And this is one example of a precast field channel having, say, around 3 meter length and a simple system of 1 foot at the bottom. So this can easily be lifted by 2 persons and put it in any field channel. You can get produce it on a mass scale. This is another example when I was working as a supreme engineer at Bultana. The rooftop of this pump house has been casted entirely in ferro cement in just 1/3 cost, which was stipulated for the RCC structure over there. The arch type room were casted on this one pump house. You can see in the upper photograph, without any centering, the height is at around 8 meters and the span is 9 meters by 20 meters long. And similarly, even this single arch was also found a little bit costlier. So in the next pump house, we have just rotated it in 90 degrees. Multi arches were tried and further economy was achieved. So both these roof structures are well casted, I think, in 2011. So you can see the durability of it also. This is a small ferro cement tank having 10,000 liters capacity. The construction is done by the farmers on their own. Only the technical guidance was given. Such around 40,000 tanks have been casted in only Konkan area in last 2 years back. So this technology has already reached with the farmers. They are using it very nicely. They are learning basically very fast and casting on their own. This is a shaped big water tank, 1.2 million liters capacity, built near Pune. This is a this is a typical ferro cement bandhara which was casted first time near Bhutalwadi in Pune. The cost of this around 100 meter long bandhara was only 80,000 5 years ago. This is a small dam after construction. 3 meter high ferro cement dam in Dholia district. This is again another good example of use of this ferro cement. The existing road bridge was converted into bridge cum bandhara by attaching such kind of petals in ferro cement. And you can see the lower picture where the water is stored against it, and if it is in excess, it will pass through under the bridge very nicely. Thin wall housing can also be. And this is a good example of retrofitting of damaged structures. So such columns can easily be repaired by jacketing the ferro cement. Even we are trying many city works on the Nira canal system. There are applications in water conservation. I will just rush through it because time is very short. But here, a good project can be planned to have different designs of CNB, the conventional cement nala bar, into ferro cement. This is a typical cross section of the CNB. Two ferro cement walls having 2 inch thick can be parallel erected, and in between you can fill the boulders and some soil and give the water ready for smaller heights. And such in this way you can have a series of bandhara over any nala, which will recharge the groundwater, stop the erosion, and increase the retention time of water. Curved bandhara on any nala. So this is the skeleton type of skeleton used for such bandhara. This is the top view. A simple section like this can also be casted. A simple ferro cement wall in between as a pedal wall. And both sides you can fill any material locally available. Low cost, simple bandhara is ready. This can be casted outside the skeleton and the chicken mesh. Just put this on site, and just within 2 to 3 days, your bandhara becomes ready. These are some bigger snaps of bandhara. Here is this is almost 15 meters high ferro cement bandhara. So particularly focusing the water structure, water sector, these are the numerous applications. And I will now going to take you to the different structures casted in India as well as abroad using this technology. See, this is the shape of very irregular shape of this dome, which is casted at Ahmedabad. And way back in 1976, and this building has taken many seismic loads during that Bhuj earthquake and other things, but nothing has happened to this structure. So it has proven this property. This was casted in 1976 again, the smaller domes in ferro cement. Even the bamboo can also be used as a such complicated shapes can easily be casted using this ferro cement. This is in Ghaziabad, UP. This temple is in Pune city, Ramakrishna temple. All the individual petal is casted in ferro cement, and then it was erected on top of it. This is is a spherical tank, elevated, having 120,000 liters. This is again a pontoon, Dugav Lake, casted entirely in pellow cement. These are some canopies to the masjid in Nasik. Different shapes of the water tanks, the spiral staircases, ventilator rooftop in Pune, some digesters, big cylindrical shapes. All this is a Nala diversion I just mentioned. This was the process, and this is the final pipeline. These are the grain storage silos at Nala. This is the retaining wall constructed for various hotels, the pyramids. Such huge structures can be done without any formwork or even gate, entrance gates, and arches to make any kind of design. You can see structure, beautiful landscape items can also be casted in pellow cement. This is the largest solar receptor panel in Pondicherry. This is a motor shed in the same campus. This is precast roofing elements. This is bamboo from pellow cement Bandara. This is the entire bungalow is casted in pellow cement right here in Dugav, around 5,000 square feet of carpet area. And it is a circular shape. Not a single wall is straight. These are beautiful bungalows constructed in Kerala, entirely in pellow cement. Shade roofs. This is a petal shaped sit out casted by the students of Government College of Engineering. This is one unique training center where just established around 2 months before near Saswat, where it's at actually orphanage. The students were trained to cast in this pellow cement, and they have casted the water tank of 10,000 capacity in their own campus. And here you can see the small children can also cast this pellow cement water tank. We have completed this structure in just 3 days. It's a beautiful bungalow, farmhouse bungalow near Satara, 2000 square foot carpet. This is the interior of the same bungalow, entirely casted in pellow cement. There are beautiful other structures which we have casted. This holy kalash symbol, height is around 50 feet of that kalash. This site is 50 casted in Gujarat. Here you can have the big entrance gates of any shape. These are pellow cement huts or gazebo of different shapes. These are 3.5 meter high pellow cement bandala recently casted in Sangli. Now it is giving a very nice vision. This was seen at international conference on investment development in India. So there were some experts in investment. This is a beautiful sewage purification tank in Brazil, casting in investment way back in 1951. You can notice the thickness of the walls is hardly 1 inch, 20 the entire tank. These are some strength through shapes by casting such C-shaped channels and putting it upside down. You can have the roofing material ready for that. These are some pellow cement bandalas. This is the highest dam ever casted in pellow cement, 30 meters high in Brazil. This was the photograph at the foundation of the same dam. And see the different design aspects. They have achieved the shape, strength through shapes, This is a big cultural center, multi-story center. Having this span, this slab, laid 2 inches thick, and the columns are also very slender. So this thing can be achieved only by first gate of a cement company. This is a beautiful farmhouse of the Ferro Cement in huge area, around 10,000 square feet. This is the interior of the same Bangalore. I will show you unique Ferro Cement Bandala, which is casted at the end, so that and know the more versatile properties of this material. It's okay. Hello. Can you hear me? Okay. So with this friends, I conclude this my small presentation on ferro cement technology. Sky is the limit. You can learn more about this technique through the various materials available, through the ferro cement technology, our own handbook published by our own WRD, and make usage of this very excellent and versatile material, which is much more useful for our water infrastructures. So I wish you all the best and hoping to see you soon. Thank you. If any questions or answers, if you are having some doubt, you are free to ask now.
You can raise the hand and ask the question from our side.
सर प्रश्न विचार सर रामचंद्र क्षीरसागर सर
सर तुम्ही
सर तुम्ही रामचंद्रन निटूरकर साहेब
सर
विचारू शकता.
नमस्कार पवार साहेब.
नमस्कार नमस्कार बोला
सर. सर द प्रेजेंटेशन वॉज एक्सलेंट. ऑफकोर्स आई एम ए फेरू सीमेंट लाइफ मेंबर बट इट वॉज वेरी प्लेजेंट टू हियर यू सर. यू गेव ऑल डिटेल इन्फॉर्मेशन स्पेशली फॉर स्पेशली द बिगिनर्स हु हैव नॉट सो कम अक्रॉस सो फार द फेरू सीमेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. दे विल बी गेटिंग ए लॉट ऑफ नॉलेज फ्रॉम दिस फेरू सीमेंट. आई एम थैंकफुल टू यू सर. थैंकफुल टू यू.
Okay, thank you. But I suppose the use of this technology should be used in water sector by WRD and even Water Conservation Department both. And if they work together in this field, certainly many things can be achieved. Thank you.
ओके नमस्कार पवार सर.
नमस्कार बोला
सर. सर मी बाय प्रोफेशन आर्किटेक्ट आहे आणि विकॅड विश्वविद्यालय कॉलेजला फॅकल्टी देखील आहे. सर माझा प्रश्न असा आहे की फेरो सिमेंट मध्ये जेव्हा आपण कुठलाही शेप जेव्हा घेतो तर त्याच्यामध्ये जे बेसिक रेनफोर्समेंट आपण विचार करतो आहे त्याचे काही कॅल्क्युलेशन आपण कन्सिडर करायचे की एक बेसिक थंबरूल प्रमाणे आपण ते करायचं. प्रश्न नंबर एक. आणि दोन की आपण डायरेक्टली त्याला काही कंटेंट टाकून म्हणजे त्याचा कलर चेंज करू शकतोय का.
ओके तुमच्या पहिल्या प्रश्नाचं उत्तर मी आधी देतो. हे फेरो सिमेंटचे जे काही शेप्स आहेत ते केवळ आर्किटेक्चर ड्रॉइंग नुसार बनवून किंवा थंबरूल केलेले अजिबात नाहीत. इट इज एक्झॅक्टली द सिमिलर प्रोसिजर ऍज लाईक आरसीसी. द सेम आयएस कोड्स अँड ऑल द प्रॅक्टिसेस आर अवेलेबल अँड दोज आर यूज व्हाइल द डिझाईनिंग ऑफ दिस सच फेरो सिमेंट स्ट्रक्चर्स. त्याच्यामध्ये आपण डिझाईन करू शकतो ऍज अ मेंबर ऍज वेल ऍज you can achieve additional strength through different shapes. So this way it is perfectly and scientifically designed. This is the answer to the first question. And about the second one, you can certainly add some admixtures to give different colors to the cement, as like you can use the color cement. Similarly, you can add it while casting, or even you can paint it in the latter stage. Both ways it is possible.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
वैभव जगताप साहेब तुम्हाला अनम्यूट करण्यात आलं आहे. आपण प्रश्न विचारू. आपण म्युटेड आहात. अनम्यूट करा आणि आपला प्रश्न विचार.
हॅलो नमस्कार. प्रेझेंटेशन इज व्हेरी नाईस.
बोला ना. बोला
ना. माय कलीग इज सजेस्टेड मी फॉर दॅट. I want to build one small type of bandara in my village. So Oda.
Which village?
So can I get guidance from your?
Hello? Certainly. Which village? Tumcha gaav kutlya jilhyat aahe? Kutun bolta aap? Hello.
Pune jilhya madhe Baramati talukya madhe aahe Saimbachi wadi manun.
ओके त्याच्यासाठी तुम्हाला इथं पुण्यामध्ये ओके नाही त्यासाठी तुम्हाला इथं पुण्यामध्ये फेरो सिमेंट सोसायटी म्हणून एक ऑफिस आहे. ते तुम्हाला फ्रीली हे टेक्नॉलॉजी अवेलेबल करून देतात, तुम्हाला गायडन्स मिळेल आणि त्याचे डिझाईन मिळतील आणि त्याच्या प्रमाणात तुम्ही गावकरी मिळून स्वतः समाधानाने किंवा एखाद्या छोट्या कॉन्ट्रॅक्टरला देऊन तुम्ही ते कास्ट करू शकता. अतिशय कमी खर्चामध्ये कमी वेळेमध्ये तुम्ही या गोष्टी करू शकाल. आणि यासाठीच वॉटर कॉन्झर्वेशन डिपार्टमेंटचं जे काही पुण्यामधलं ऑफिस आहे ते पण तुम्हाला मदत नक्की करू शकेल. आणि अशा पद्धतीचे बंधारे जिथं बांधलेले आहेत ते तुम्ही पाहून येऊ शकता आणि त्या पद्धतीने तुम्हाला हा गायडन्स या सोसायटीकडून किंवा वॉटर कॉन्झर्वेशन डिपार्टमेंटच्या कुठल्याही ऑफिस कडून नक्की मिळेल.
ओके, थँक्यू सर.
ओके, थँक्यू.
थँक्यू सर.
अरुण घाटे साहेब, तुम्हाला अनम्यूट करण्यात आलं आहे, आपण प्रश्न विचारू शकता.
हॅलो. हा सर, ऐकायला येत ना?
बोला.
तर मला हे विचारायचं होतं की आपण हर्टिंग साठी रिप्लेसमेंट म्हणून हे करू शकतो असं आपण म्हणलेलं आहे, तर तसा कोणता प्रयोग केलेला आहे का?
तसा प्रयोग ऍक्च्युअली एक्झिक्युशन मध्ये कोणी केलाय की नाही माहित नाही, पण आपल्याला तो नक्की करता येईल. तसं एखादा कॅनलचं एम्बॅंकमेंट असेल किंवा इव्हन डॅम मध्ये आपण जसं स्मॉल डॅम असेल तर आपण मध्ये हर्टिंग म्हणून काळी माती वापरतो. हे आपण पाणी इम्पर्मेबिलिटी त्याची वाढवण्यासाठी म्हणून ते आपण काळी माती टाकतो. त्याच्या ऐवजी जर मध्ये आपण पेरोसिमेंटची वॉल उभी केली तर दॅट क्रिएट्स परफेक्ट बॅरियर फॉर द वॉटर टू पास. आणि मग त्याच्याकडे आपण फक्त सपोर्ट म्हणून काही गेसिंग मटेरियल किंवा लोकली अवेलेबल बोल्डर्स अशा पद्धतीने उभं केलं तर आपल्याला हे स्मॉल डॅम म्हणून नक्की अशा पद्धतीचं बांधकाम करता येईल.
पण सीडीओ आपला डिझाईन करून देणार का, याला सपोर्ट करता का?
हो, सीडीओ मध्ये अशा पद्धतीचे डिझाईन्स त्यांनी केलेले आहेत, त्याप्रमाणे बांधकामही झालेले आहेत. आणि जर तुम्ही काही एखादं प्रायव्हेट डिझाईन करून घेऊन गेला तर त्याचं वेटिंग सुद्धा तुम्हाला सीडीओ मध्ये करून मिळू शकतं.
मला दुसरा प्रश्न विचारायचा होता सर की आपल्याला हायएस्ट किती मीटरचं, म्हणजे मला समजा 25 मीटर उंचीचं धरण बांधायचंय फेरोमध्ये, तर आपल्याला या पद्धतीने करता येईल का?
मी आताच मागाशी प्रेझेंटेशन मध्ये दाखवलं, ब्राझील मध्ये 30 मीटर उंचीचं या पेरोसिमेंट मधलं धरण बांधलेलं आहे. अर्थात त्याच्यासाठी डिझाईन कन्सेप्ट थोडे वेगळे वापरून त्यातलं टेक्निक काय आहे हे समजून घेतलं पाहिजे. आपले जे मोठ्या धरणांचे डिझाईन असतात हे ग्रॅव्हिटी डॅम्स म्हणून असतात. तिथं त्याला मग वेगळा शेप देऊ नये, पहिल्यांदा आज शेप दिल्यामुळे त्याच्या अजून कॅपॅसिटी वाढवलेली आहे. त्याच्यानंतर त्याच्यामध्ये बॉक्सेस तयार केलेले आहेत, मध्ये मध्ये पिन्स टाकलेले आहेत. हे जे तांत्रिक डिटेल्स आहे ते लक्षात घेऊन आपल्याला नक्की त्या डॅम बांधता येतो. आणि तसा आपण पाहिलं की ब्राझील मध्ये अशा पद्धतीचा डॅम डिझाईन करून त्यांनी बांधलेला आहे आणि त्याचं प्रेझेंटेशन सुद्धा त्यांनी त्या इंटरनॅशनल कॉन्फरन्स मध्ये केलेलं मी स्वतः पाहिलेलं. त्यामुळे आपल्याला बांधकाम नक्कीच कसं करतो.
डिटेल्स मिळतील का सर? डिटेल्स मिळतील आपल्याला?
हो, डिटेल्स मिळतील ना. त्यांच्या डिझाईनचे वेबसाईट वर तुम्हाला ते सगळे डिटेल्स त्याचे डिझाईनचे किंवा ह्याचे अवेलेबल होऊ शकतात. किंवा ज्यांनी बांधला त्याच्याशी जर आपण ईमेल जो संपर्क केला त्याची माहिती मिळू शकेल.
चालेल.
प्रश्न असा आहे की आज आपल्याकडे 25 मीटर उंचीचं धरण बांधायला जागाच कुठे शिल्लक आहे, त्यामुळे आता मोठ्या उंचीपेक्षा आता छोटी छोटी जी जलसंधारणाची काम आहे, छोटे बांधणारे 1.5 मीटर 2 मीटर उंचीचे हेच बांधण्याची जास्त गरज आहे. ते जर तुम्ही फेरोसिमेंट मध्ये बांधले एका नाल्यावरती 10-10 सेरीज मध्ये तुम्ही बांधू शकता आणि त्याचा जास्त उपयोग आज आपल्याला होतो आणि त्याची जास्त आवश्यकता आहे.
आपण हा जो लाइनिंगचा जो प्रयोग केलेला आहे त्याचे काही फीडबॅक आहे का? लाइनिंग आपण जे केलेलं आहे फेरो मध्ये,
हो, आपण मगाशी मी जे दाखवलं प्रेझेंटेशन मध्ये पुनर जे नाशिक मध्ये धरण आहे त्याच्या कालव्यावर आपण ते केलेलं आहे. ते मला वाटतं ऑलमोस्ट 10-12 वर्षापूर्वी केलेलं आहे. आजही ते अतिशय उत्तम स्थितीत आहे, त्याला क्रॅक्स नाहीत आणि त्यामुळे वॉटर लिकेज पूर्णपणे थांबलेलं आहे. फक्त एवढंच आहे की आता हेच आपण जे प्रयोग तिथे केला तो मोठ्या प्रमाणात आपण इतर प्रकल्पाच्या सगळ्याच कॅनलवरती आळवून जर आपण केला तर निश्चितपणे आपल्याला वॉटर लिकेज वाचवायला मदत होऊ शकेल.
हा कारण
ओके
मोठ्या प्रमाणात आपण लाइनिंगला करायला स्कोप असून सुद्धा आपण लाइनिंगला प्रीकास्ट करत राहतो, म्हणजे विदाउट स्टील आणि प्लेन सिमेंट वापरतो.
नवीन आहे वॉटर रिसोर्स डिपार्टमेंटच्या अभियंत्यांना सुद्धाही नवीन आहे आणि हळूहळू त्या पद्धतीने त्याचं डिझाईन्स आणि मग एक्झिक्युशन चालू झाले की त्याचा मोठ्या प्रमाणात वापर चालू. ओके
आता हे ड्रीप मध्ये आणि जे नवीन करायचं आहे त्याच्यामध्ये आपल्याला जे पुनर्स्थापना करायची आहे प्रकल्पांची, जुने आता काही काही जे प्रकल्प आहेत आता समजा जीआरबीसी किंवा आता ह्या ह्याचे जे 100-100 वर्षापूर्वीचे कॅनल आहेत हे रिस्टोर करताना आपण या पद्धतीने करायला पाहिजे असं.
हो त्याच्याबद्दल आपण वापर केलेला आहे. मगाशी मी एक उदाहरण सांगितलं, निळा कालव्यावरती 100 वर्ष 150 वर्षापूर्वीचे काही बांधकाम आहेत तर त्याचा दुरुस्ती, त्याचं सक्षमीकरण, मजबूतीकरण हे आपण याच फेरोसिमेंट टेक्नॉलॉजीच्या सहाय्याने केलेलं आहे. 10 वर्षापूर्वी सुद्धा आपण अशा कामांना सुरुवात केलेली आहे आणि खूप चांगल्या पद्धतीने त्याचा उपयोग आपण केलेला आहे आणि करतोय.
थँक्यू सर.
थँक्यू.
थँक्यू सर.
जयसिंग
हिरे साहेब
आपण आपला प्रश्न विचारू शकता, आपल्याला विचारू शकता, आपल्याला अनम्यूट करण्यात आले.
सर गुड मॉर्निंग सर. सर माय क्वेश्चन इज दॅट आय सीन दॅट मोस्टली इन केस ऑफ द ब्रिज कम बंधारा आणि इन बंधारा विच इज कन्स्ट्रक्टेड बाय द फेरोसिमेंट, तर आय सीन दॅट द स्ट्रक्चर डिझाईन देर इज अ नो वेस्ट वेअर प्रोव्हिजन आर मेड. So if in and also seen that the water is stored up to the near about HFL levels or mostly touches to the high bank of the both side rivers. So if the more floods are come from that, so there is a no provisions up to pass out the, that flood through that waste weir. So is there any
yes, yeah. I will answer to that. I understood your question. Basically, we are talking about a small bandhara and regular dam which is having regular spillway and waste weir. That concept is totally different. And for small bandharas, there is no waste weir provision is required because the bandharas are normally used for the low discharges where there are low floods. And whenever the flood occurs or the water level increases, the water passes over through that bandhara. So the entire length of that bandhara acts as a spillway of the waste weir. So this is the general concept. So here in that bridge cum bandhara, you have noticed that bridge road top is at the upper level, whereas the ferrocement bandhara, which were casted in semicircular shape, which are at lower level. So that is the crest level of that bandhara. So that is the maximum level against which the water can be stored. Whenever the flood comes, the water passes over that ferrocement curvature, falls in the pipeline below the bridge, and then it passes up. So it is actually functioning. You must have seen in the last video.
Yeah.
So both ways it is functioning very nicely. Of course, if you construct a ferrocement regular dam, then that separate spillway provision is needed, and it can be done by just lowering some part as a crest. So both things are possible.
Yes, sir. Yes, thanks, sir. Nice.
Thank you.
वैभव जगताप साहेब करण्यात आला आहे, आपण आपला प्रश्न.
हॅलो. हा वैभव जी बोला. तुमचा आवाज येत नाही एवढे बोलली, अनम्यूट करा आणि बोला. ओके काही टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लेम. नेक्स्ट पेज.
चालेल.
I think the questions are over. Of course, you can always contact for any further queries or by email or SMS or a direct call.
Thank you. Questions are over. PPT will be available on our website. So you can anytime refer to that.
Thank you.
Hello, brother. Is it?